2 more days to decide who would take home that trophy right there in the 119th Connecticut Amateur Championship with quarterfinal and semifinal action. We'd have an exciting quarterfinal between Cody Paladino and Rick Dowling. Here you see Paladino on 15. Big birdie putt there and an even bigger fist pump to go one up with just 3 to play. But then flash forward to 16. Rick Dowling able to swirl that birdie putt home to take the whole fist pump for Dowling himself, as things would be tied with just 2 holes to play. Now we flash forward to 17. Another clutch putt here from Paladino. Tracks that one into the bottom of the cup. Another big fist pump for Paladino as he would then go one up going to 18. But then on 18, his drive would find the left side fairway bunker. Catches a lot of sand there on his approach shot. And that would come up well short. And that would leave the door just slightly open here for Rick Dowling. And Dowling is able to put his putt here within a couple of inches. And he would be able to take the hole as we would play extra holes. And in that extra holes here on the number 2, it would be all Paladino. Here you see his approach shot going to catch the ridge here and float down to within just a couple of feet of the hole, as Paladino seemed like he had it on lock once he hit that shot. And then Dowling didn't have similar luck. His approach shot would find the left side bunker, an errant chip out of that bunker, and then a long putt to try to extend the match, and he's not able to get it to go, as Paladino would move on to the semifinals against Adam Friedman. And in that semifinal, Paladino seemed like he had it on lock to begin with. Here on 3, hits a long birdie putt there to go 2 up early on. Then flash forward all the way to 14. Paladino just needs a 2 putt here to seal the deal. And that's going to easily lock it up with that putt within a couple of inches, as Paladino reflects on his round on Thursday.
I mean, the morning was an unbelievable match with Rick. We both played, you know, very well, and there were a lot of, especially in the back nine, a lot of really, you know, clutch putts and clutch shots by both folks. So, you know, the putt on 15 was obviously huge, but then he makes an unbelievable up and down on 16, and he had just made a huge putt on 14, and then I make one on 17. So it was just back and forth. I didn't look at the scorecard yet, but I think someone won almost every hole is what I think was kind of going on. And the match was always, you know, all square, one up, or now it was 2 up, but I never trailed, which I think was important.
Then we would have the marquee match of the day between the 27 seed Drew Brennan and your defending amateur champion Chris Fosdick. It would not disappoint. Here you see on 16, long par putt there from Brennan just off the edge of the green. As now he would only be 1 down going into hole 17, and on 17, Brennan with another opportunity for birdie here. He's able to twist that one into the bottom of the cup, as Brennan with a couple of clutch putts on 16 and 17 to knot things up going into 18. And here on 18, this putt here from Chris Fosdick rolls right in there, and it seemed like that was going to be the putt that maybe sent Fosdick back to another amateur final. But Drew Brennan would have other ideas. He steps up and is looking about a 15-footer here. And he's able to tap that one right into the bottom of the cup. Some excitement there from Brennan as we would play extra holes. Fosdick here on number 2 has an opportunity to win it, but leaves that one just wide. But it wouldn't be too much longer here at hole number 3 after an errant drive from Brennan. That putt to try to extend the match as Chris Fosdick reaches his second consecutive final. He reflects on getting another crack at Paladino.
I wanted this to happen again. I think it's going to be a lot of fun. Hopefully, if it's another match like last year, it'll be one that a lot of people would want to watch, and I'm just really excited for it.
There you see it lined up. Paladino versus Fosdick, round number 2 here, the 2021 and the 119th Connecticut Amateur Final, as we will be bringing you the action all day long live on our social media.